moving to the one more problem on Cauchy-Riemann equation. The problem is, show that f of z is equals to z raised to n, where n is a positive integer, is analytic. That is, f of z is z raised to n is analytic, and hence find its derivative, means f dash of z. So here you write, by data it is given f of z is equals to z raised to n. Now take z is equals to r into e raised to I theta. We have u plus iv, that is w is equals to u plus iv, complex number. W is equal to f of z is equal to z raised to n. U plus iv is equals to here z r into e raised to I theta raised to n. This is equals to r raised to n, split this, e raised to I n theta. So splitting r raised to n, next e raised to I n theta is equals to r raised to n e raised to I n theta. In terms of trigonometric function, it is cos n theta plus I sin n theta. So this is u is equals to r raised to n cos n theta plus I sin theta. So u plus iv is equal to this much. Now real part, u is equals to r raised to n cos n theta, and imaginary part, so v is equals to r raised to n sin n theta. Next, differentiate u with respect to r, you get cos n theta. Variable here theta is r raised to n, so this much, this will be constant. Differentiate this only, n into r raised to n minus 1 cos n theta. This is u r. Next u theta, means differentiate with respect to theta, constant, this time r n is constant, so r raised to n cos theta in cos n theta is minus sin n theta, and this time here n theta differentiate with respect to theta, so it will remains n into r raised to n sin n theta. So similarly here differentiate with respect to r, so it becomes r raised to n, so it is, this term is constant, this means n into r raised to n minus 1 sin n theta. Next, with respect to theta, so r raised to n is constant, sin n theta becomes cos n theta, and differentiate n theta, it is n into r raised to n cos n theta. Now Cauchy-Riemann equation, in the polar form r into u r is equals to v theta, and r into vr is equals to minus u theta are satisfied. So ur is equals to v theta, so ur is equals to v theta, and this one r vr, so shift this one, r v r is equals to minus u theta. Here minus symbol is there, u theta. That means conditions are satisfied. Thus, f of z is equals to z raised to n is analytic. Next, we have to find f dash of z. You can write also we have f dash of z is equals to f of z is equals to z raised to n means r into e raised to I theta. So e raised to, so we have by analytic it is e raised to minus I theta in polar form. U r plus I v r. This is from theorem, that is f dash of z is equals to e raised to minus I theta. U r is nothing but n r raised to n minus 1 cos n theta plus I into v r. This again v r n into r raised to n minus 1 sin n theta, n into r raised to n minus 1 sin n theta. So this is equals to n into r raised to n minus 1, n into r raised to n minus 1 common. So it is n into r raised to n minus 1 into e raised to minus I theta, already it is there outside the bracket. So remains cos n theta plus I sin n theta. This is equals to n into r raised to n minus 1 e raised to minus I theta, and this will becomes imaginary real parts. It is e raised to I n theta is equals to cos n theta plus I sin n theta. E raised to I n theta is nothing but e raised to n theta plus I sin n theta. So n into r raised to n minus 1 e raised to I theta n into r raised to n minus 1 e raised to I theta. So it becomes n minus 1. So n into r raised to n minus 1 e raised to I theta n minus 1. This is equals to n into r raised to n minus 1 e raised to I theta n minus 1. So this is equals to n into r into e raised to I theta raised to n minus 1. Since z is equals to r into e raised to I theta, so f dash of z is equals to n into z raised to n minus 1. This is the complete solution for this type of problem.